Souvenir by Philip K. Dick, narrated by Mark Bowen. "Here we go, sir," the robot pilot said. The words startled Rogers and made him look up sharply. He tensed his body and adjusted the trace web inside his coat as the bubble ship started dropping, swiftly and silently toward the planet's surface. This, his heart caught, was Williamson's world, the legendary lost planet, found after 3 centuries. By accident, of course. This blue and green planet, the holy grail of the galactic system, had been almost miraculously discovered by a routine charting mission. Frank Williamson had been the first Terran to develop an outer space drive, the first to hop from the solar system toward the universe beyond. He had never come back. He, his world, his colony, had never been found. There had been endless rumors, false leads, fake legends, and nothing more. "I'm receiving field clearance." The robot pilot raised the gain on the control speaker and clicked to attention. "Field ready," came a ghostly voice from below. "Remember, your drive mechanism is unfamiliar to us. How much run is required? Emergency brake walls are up." 300 years. It had been a long time to find Williamson's world. Many authorities had given him up. Some believed he had never landed, had died out in space. Perhaps there was no Williamson's world. Certainly there had been no real clues, nothing tangible to go on. Frank Williamson and 3 families had utterly disappeared in the trackless void, never to be heard from again. Until now. The young man met him at the field. He was thin and red-haired, and dressed in a colorful suit of bright material. "You're from the Galactic Relay Center?" he asked. "That's right," Rogers said huskily. "I'm Edward Rogers." The young man held out his hand. Rogers shook it awkwardly. "My name is Williamson," the young man said. "Gene Williamson." The name thundered in Rogers' ears. "Are you?" The young man nodded, his gaze enigmatical. "I'm his great-great-great-great-grandson. His tomb is here. You may see it if you wish." "I almost expected to see him. He's, well, almost a god figure to us. The first man to break out of the solar system." "He means a lot to us, too," the young man said. "He brought us here. They searched a long time before they found a planet that was habitable." Williamson waved at the city, stretched out beyond the field. "This one proves satisfactory. It's the system's 10th planet." Roger's eyes began to shine. Williamson's world, under his feet. He stamped hard as they walked down the ramp together, away from the field. How many men in the galaxy had dreamed of striding down a landing ramp onto Williamson's world with a young descendant of Frank Williamson beside them? "They'll all want to come here," Williamson said, as if aware of his thoughts. "Throw rubbish around and break off the flowers. Pick up handfuls of dirt to take back." He laughed a little nervously. "The relay will control them, of course." "Of course," Rogers assured him. At the ramp end, Rogers stopped short. For the first time, he saw the city. "What's wrong?" Gene Williamson asked, with a faint trace of amusement. They had been cut off, of course. Isolated, so perhaps it wasn't so surprising. It was a wonder they weren't living in caves eating raw meat. But Williamson had always symbolized progress, development. He had been a man ahead of other men. True, his space drive, by modern standards, had been primitive, a curiosity. But the concept remained unaltered. Williamson the pioneer and inventor. The man who built. Yet the city was nothing more than a village, with a few dozen houses and some public buildings and industrial units at its perimeter. Beyond the city stretched...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.